All right, so to make your key drawing, the first thing you need to check is your extrusions. Your extrusions should be new bodies. If this says join, you need to change it to new body for all of these arms that are extending from your key. All three of your extrusions, come down here in your timeline, check your extrusions, double check, make sure they all say new body. Once they say new body, you will have a portion of your browser over here that says bodies. I don't see mine because I already made components, but you'll see a portion over here that says bodies, and you will right click where it says bodies and you will create components from those bodies. Mine are already components. So I have the key and I've got the three arms. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with the key and we're going to right click, create a drawing. Down here in the sheet size, we're going to make it this second choice for A, 11 by 8.5. And we are going to place this view. Once it loads, okay, we're going to place this view and make sure the scale is 1:1. We're placing the front view 1:1. Just place it anywhere. Now we're going to click on the title block and delete it. I'm going to click on the border and delete it. I don't want any of that stuff in my way. And now I'm going to rotate the key up here under modify. I can use this spinny circle and rotate. I'm going to rotate it based on the endpoint. I'm going to put it at an angle, click OK. And then I can drag it back down into the corner. So I am going to need to rotate it again. It's not quite ready yet. So I'm still going to use this corner down here just because I have better luck that way. I'm going to zoom out so I can see what I'm doing. And there. So my key fits totally on this page. Now, to print this, I'm going to click Output PDF, All Sheets, and I'm going to open the PDF, click OK. Save it to your desktop or your user drive, wherever you want to save it. Key drawing. And then the PDF should automatically load for you. And when you go to print this, you will need to print it from the Great Oaks computer. So you might need to email it to yourself or save it in your OneDrive. Email it to yourself or save it to your OneDrive. Log into the Great Oaks computer and then open up your email or open up your OneDrive. You should be able to find this. My printer is 4250. Mrs. Wilson's printer will be something similar. And then down here in orientation, you need to tell the printer that this should be landscape. Otherwise, the printer is going to scale it and make it fit on a portrait sheet, and it won't be the proper size. So make sure you tell it it's landscape and print that page, okay? To print the arms for the key, we're going to go back to the drawing. Actually, we can do it right here from the drawing. We can double-click. And instead of a custom orientation, I can tell it to give me the, oh, that's not working. Okay, let's go back to our model. And I'm gonna right click on that first arm and I'm gonna create a drawing. I wanna put it on the same sheet. So instead of creating a new drawing, I'm gonna put it on that same sheet. Notice how the size already changed for me. And I'm gonna place this drawing. I don't want the front view, I want the right view. And I want the scale to be 1:1. So I'm gonna place this right in the middle of the page. And I wanna see all the visible hidden edges. And I can turn on the other three arms. So I can turn all of those on. Now I can see the small arm, the medium sized arm, and the large arm. And I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna output this PDF. I'm going to tell it to open right away. I'm going to put it on my desktop again. I'm going to call it Key Arms. Okay, that didn't work. Let's close that and try again. I'm going to go ahead and save this as Key Drawing. And I will try again to do that output PDF. Oh, there it is. Okay. It's on sheet two. So over here on the left-hand side, sheet one, sheet two, here's my my drawing that I want to print. And when I print this one, I'm going to print it three times. The first time, So up here where it says copies, 1, 2, 3, print it landscape, click print. Now I'll have one copy to cut out for the small rectangle, one copy to cut out for the medium rectangle, and one copy to cut out for the large rectangle. For your cams, you're going to need to open up another new page, and you're going to save it as all cams. And then you will be able to pull in your hex cam. And you'll see this linked file right there. Click OK. We're going to pull in the pair cam. It's going to put these two right on top of each other. And you see your three axes here. You can drag it over so they're not on top of each other. That's fine. Zoom out so you can see what you're doing. My eccentric cam, it doesn't matter where you click, it's going to put them on top of each other, and then you're going to need to move them around afterwards. Click OK. And I'm still missing a cam. Oh, snail cam, there it is. Come on, snail cam. I did a right click, insert into current design. There we go. Now I've got all three of my cams. It doesn't matter how they're lined up. We're just going to use these to create a drawing. So I'm going to right click on my hex cam. I'm going to create a new drawing. I'm going to use size A again. Click OK. I'm going to place it 1:1. And I'm going to get it right on the edge of the paper. Again, I'm going to delete my table block and my border, so that all I can see now is that cam. I'm not quite on the page, so I'm going to slide it down ever so slightly just so that it is definitely on the page. Come on, hex cam. Okay, maybe I'm going to move you over here. There we go. And now I can turn on my other cams. Nope, don't want to do that. Now I'm going to create a new drawing, and I'm going to put it on my drawing where the hex cam is, putting my pair cam into my hex cam drawing. I'm going to place it 1:1 right over here. And the pair cam is going to fit better if we rotate it sideways and try to make it fit with the hex cam. Okay, we might have to do the cam drawings all separately.